ओके वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू. आई एम दुर्गेश कुमार पांडे. आई एम टेकिंग दिस क्लास एंड दिस क्लास इज अ पॉलिटिकल साइंस एंड द चैप्टर इज कोल्ड वॉर एरा. स्टूडेंट्स यू नो द कोल्ड वॉर इज अ टेंशन. अ कोल्ड वॉर इज अ कंपटीशन. द कोल्ड वॉर इज अ series of confrontation between US and USSR and backed by their respective allies. So this Cold War is between two powerful countries, US and USSR. You know, US follow the ideology of liberal democracy and capitalism, and USSR follow the idea of socialism and communism. Capitalism propagate the private property and communism oppose the private property. These two blocks are opposite in their ideology. So this is also an ideological war. Cold War is also is an ideological war among the two powerful blocs. And during the Cold War era, this is a time between 1945 to 1989. This was the long duration. So these two powerful blocs, US and USSR, are always trying to criticize each other, and they were trying to prove themselves a superior country. So this Cold War is also an ideological war. In this long period, sometimes this war, Cold War, was become very acute, like a Cuban Missile Crisis in 1961 and 62. You know about the Cuban Missile Crisis. In 1961, there was a fear in the Cuba that the USA would attack on Cuba and capture on Cuba. This was the fear. And on those times, Cuba was an alliance of USSR, and Cuba is headed by a communist ideology party like a Fidel Castro. Fidel Castro was a communist and he was a very popular leader. The Cuba got financial and diplomatic support from USSR. And Cuba is the neighboring country of USA. So USSR was very worried. This was a fear that the USA was attack on the Cuba and capture upon them. So USSR was decided to convert the Cuba as a Russian base. And USSR install a nuclear weapons in Cuba. When the information got about this by President of USA, JF Kennedy, he was very angry and he was trying to best to oppose this. And JF Kennedy warned the USSR for such activity. The condition in the 1962 was very acute. In 1962, during the Cuba Missile Crisis, the danger was very acute. There was a chance of a new world war. So Cold War on those days as their peak. But after some times, when the leaders were changed in USA and USSR, like after the death of Stalin in USSR, the new leaders, and after the leaders, they were different minded, they were some liberal. And similarly, the new leaders of USA were also liberals. So after some time, these Cold Wars reduced among these two blocks. And this time is known as detain, mean relaxation of the Cold War, detain. Detain means the relaxation of Cold War, okay? And now, yes, and USSR were come together and try to talk about peace and stability. Both the blocks were agree to control the armaments, nuclear weapons. That is why they were trying to make disarmament treaty, like a NPT, nuclear non-proliferation treaty, LTBT, test ban treaty, anti-ballistic missile treaties. These were in the era of 1960s. Okay, NPT, limited test ban treaty, and anti-ballistic missile treaty. These are the some effort by these two blocks to reduce the tension among them. They were trying to cooperate with each other, and they were trying to risk of war. Both are equally powerful, and it is not good for them a hot war. That is, they were trying to cooperate, and the Cold War was reduced for few years, and this era is known as detain in the Cold War. And they were cooperate in many fields, like disarmaments. They were try to solve the world problem by discussion class. You know what is deterrence during the Cold War era? During the Cold War era, both the blocks are equally powerful, and no one take the risk of war, because both the blocks have enough armaments, nuclear weapons, and everyone is able to retaliate to each other, and it is not good a heart for them. That is the logic of deterrence. Means one block is, this deterrence is the action which is discouraging the another action and event by fear and doubts of the consequences. Means dar aur bhram paida karke हम कि उसके क्या परिणाम होंगे, हम दूसरे ब्लॉक को कुछ भी करने से रोकते हैं. दिस इज अ डिटरेंस. वन ब्लॉक्स इज द डिटरेंस इज अ एक्शन विच डिस्करेज द एक्शन और इवेंट ऑफ अनदर ब्लॉक बाई फियर एंड डाउट. बाई फियर एंड डाउट ऑफ द कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस ऑफ वॉर. तो दैट इज वाई बोथ द ब्लॉक्स आर इक्वली पावरफुल. तो नो वन कैन टेक द रिस्क ऑफ वॉर एंड बोथ ब्लॉक्स आर कैपेबल टू रिटेलिएट टू ईच अदर. सो दे आर यूजिंग डिटरेंस अमॉन्ग वंस अगेन. ओके, ड्यूरिंग कोल्ड वॉर एरा sometimes this cold war was very acute and sometimes the cold was relaxed and the situation will change after sometimes again and this relaxation convert into acute tension again after 1980 like in 1979 when the USSR sent their army in the Afghanistan, so USA was become very angry upon this action and once the USSR also doing some other activities which make the USA angry upon USSR. Like in one times or one plane is going in the field of in the space of USSR, so USSR was shoot this plane and due to this many Americans were also dying. So USA was criticized USSR for their aggressive nature. So this relaxation all again convert into tension and this is known as new Cold War started. USSR sent their army in 1979 in Afghanistan. So America was not happy with the action of USSR and America gave warning to USSR and saying not cooperate in the field of energy research in the USSR regions and not provide technology for the searching resources in the field of USSR. Means America ne bola ki mai aapki ab help nahi karunga, aapke area mein jo bhi petrol gas hai unko research karne ke liye aapko technology chahiye, mai aapko nahi dunga. So again this relaxation is converted into new cold war and this cold war was continued till 1989. You know, students, in 1985, Mikhail Gorbachev was coming to as a leader of USSR, and he was trying to again reduce the Cold War. He was trying to make the USSR democratic, make their economy open. He was organized two reforms, Perestroika and some others. With the help of this policy, he was trying to reform your society. And Mikhail Gorbachev returned back the military from Afghanistan to their country. Now the USSR are in the path of reform in the leadership of Mikhail Gorbachev. Plus, you know, Mikhail Gorbachev was a great personality and the last leader of Soviet Union. He was using so many political and economical reform like perestroika and glasnost. Okay, perestroika means restructuring and glasnost is a openness for their economy. Mikhail Gorbachev was trying to reduce the Cold War. He was left the path which is going with the race of USA. He was returned from the race of war with the US. Okay? वह USA से जो competition था उसको छोड़ दिए war का. Okay? And now he was reformed the Russia, USSR, and he was returned by the army from the Afghanistan to USA again, and he was trying to make the system democratic, and he was the last leader of Soviet Union. Class, you know, the USSR was a big power. He was spent a lots of money in the space research. He was expend lots of money for developing country, which are their satellite states, and they are in the part of USSR. He was expend lots of money to maintain the satellite states. He was expend too much money for the military purposes with the race of USA, and he was invested so much money in the army or in the nuclear weapons and for the developments of missile. These things made USSR a economically weak country, and Mikhail Gorbachev was trying to improve the situation of USSR. You know, the full form of USSR is Union of Soviet Socialist Republic, and Mikhail Gorbachev was the last leader, and you know the first leader was Lenin, but the last leader was Mikhail Gorbachev, and he was trying to improve the situation. He was trying to make this devil a god. Mikhail Gorbachev was trying to make this devil a human being, and he was trying to establish friendship with USA and other Western countries and left the path of confrontations and competitions or tensions. And you know, in 1979, one important contribution of Mikhail Gorbachev was the unification of Germany. He was taking so many steps to reduce the tension of Cold War. He was make the agreement of the Western leaders and remove the restriction which is imposed on the Western people of the Western Germany to enter the Eastern Germany. And in 1989, when the Berlin Wall was broke and the Germany will become again a unique country, unification of Germany was completed and the credit was going in the hand of Mikhail Gorbachev. Mikhail Gorbachev was a very democratic leader. Students, you know, after 1989, after the unification of Germany, the USSR was breaking into 15 small countries, some Central Asian countries, some Eastern European countries were got the independence from USSR, and USSR was disintegrated into 15 parts. You know, these parts are Lithuania, Estonia, Turkmenistan, Tajikistan, Uzbekistan, and Ukraine, Russia, Belarus. These are the some countries which are coming after the breaking of USSR into 15 parts. Plus, you know, Russia was the biggest country which was come the existence after the breaking of USSR, and Russia was taking the seat of UNO in the Security Council in the place of USSR. All the nuclear weapons and their control was going in the hand of Russia, and Russia was also got the veto power of USSR. And you know, the control button of nuclear weapons was also in the hand of Russia. A new leader in the Russia, Boris Yeltsin, was coming. He was also a great leader, and he was trying to make the situation better. Students, you also know what are the consequences of disintegration of USSR. You know, after the collapse of USSR, there is only one superpower, USA. Worlds become a unipolar, okay, in the place of bipolar. And after some time, the world become unipolar, and also the power was going in the group of countries like ASEAN and European Union become powerful. And it is proved that the liberal democracy and capitalism, this idea was better than socialism and communism. And after the disintegration of USSR, so many newly country was come into existence, like Ukraine, Belarus, Tajikistan, Uzbekistan, Poland, and most of the Eastern European countries were joined the NATO, and they were very happy from this disintegration because they feel freedom after a national moment. Okay, class, you know, this time Russia the biggest portion of USSR and the largest country, which is the best friend of India, and the cooperation between India and Russia are very good. Russia is a very good friend today also. Okay, thank you.